YouTube, what it do? It's your boy Beans the Barber. I'm here with my man Kareem.
What's good? How y'all doing? How y'all doing?
All right, today, so we're gonna talk about, you know, tips of what you need to start a YouTube page. So, you know, I've been trying to start this page for a little minute now, so right now we're gonna get it in with this haircut while we have a discussion about how to start a YouTube page.
So how you been, Beans?
Man, I've been good, man. Just, you know, staying focused, being consistent. You know, just putting the work in, man, you know?
What you talking about?
Yeah, absolutely.
And I same here, man, you know, last semester of school, so college. So I'm about to graduate. So, you know, it's crunch time, real world, man. Yeah.
Understand that, man. And you almost there? Let's keep on going.
Of course.
Well, yeah, man, like, I just want to, you know, congratulate you on that that YouTube page you started.
Mm-hmm.
I've been dealing with issues on, like, you know, getting started with a YouTube page. Mm-hmm. So what are some tips give me so I can get started, or anyone that's looking to start a YouTube page to get started?
Yeah, so I mean, with anything in life, you know, you want to find your passion, you want to find your route, and that's like with anything. So as we all know, like, as of like right now, 2020, this is like the year of like social media. Everybody's on the computer, everybody's using the internet, and everybody's trying to, you know, make money in some type of way, trying to monetize. So it's really dependent on you to figure out like what is going to be your niche. And what I mean by this is that, like, what are you going to be remembered for, you know, remembered for doing on YouTube? So this can be anything from, like, you know, you're doing something as a channel that revolves around like food, maybe music, you're like a commentator, you're doing like a podcast. What type of podcast is it? You know, it's just, you just really got to pick your route, a very specific niche, just because, you know, everybody's almost doing everything already on YouTube. So it's like, how are you going to differentiate yourself so that you can build an audience around what you're trying to, you know, express? Show to the people, to the viewers at the end of the day, because I mean, it's gonna be something, you know, you're passionate about, but at the same time, it's like you're gonna have to in some way give value to the people that's like watching you. So, you know, are you giving tips, are you giving how-tos, you know? It's, I mean, that's the same thing, but it's just really to, you know, give you ideas on how to like really think about this, because you don't want to just start something and just like, I mean, you can just like, you know, mess around, you know, for your first videos. If you're that person that doesn't know exactly, you know, what they want to do, I mean, you know, it wouldn't kill you, you know, to just start posting things that you may like, and then from there, as you keep posting, you may see some traction on a specific video, and then from that video, you'd be like, oh, maybe I should start doing more videos of this, because, you know, this is something that I'm getting more views on. This is something that, you know, my subscribers/viewers they're looking at. You know, that's where the attention is at. So you just want to position yourself around just things like your passion, or things that, you know, that already has some type of traction that you're doing to make it easier on yourself.
It makes sense, man.
Yeah.
So with that being said, what advice you would give to that person who have thought about those things, and right now they're just on the fence about, like, man, how can I start? Like, you know, like, they have the camera, they have the content, like, but they're just on the fence about, like, starting. Like, what?
Yeah.
Like,
well, this just to put this out here, like, this is with anything business related, because at the end of the day, I mean, this is a passion, but this is something that 9 times out of 10 can turn into a business if you're successful. So you got to think about this from a business standpoint. If you don't start, somebody's already started. People are already in the YouTube world. So somebody's already working 10 times harder than, you know, you are.
Right.
You're sitting down thinking about it, it's not going to get you anywhere. And that person who's already in front of you is just going to get more ahead. So you really just got to start. And I don't even mean just start doing it. You could do this in steps. It could be like 1 week, you know, you just set up your YouTube channel. Like the actual, you create like a Gmail, and then you attach it to your channel.
Right.
And you just consistently do it into steps next to, you know, you add your profile picture, you got your banner, you got your description of your page. You just really do it in steps instead of it looking at it like, I just got to start everything at once. Like, no one ever told you to do that, you know?
Right.
Make it easier at the beginning. Break everything down. Because, you know, you just don't start being successful. You got to really work towards that. How do you do that? You create steps.
Working steps, okay.
And you go forward from there.
Right, okay.
You just build on. It's like building blocks. Like, you did that part, it makes it stronger. You just keep going.
Right.
Now you're stronger to go, and you're stronger. And you can start.
Okay.
So, you know, don't think about the whole overall thing as like, I have to start. Like, make it easy on yourself and create steps. That's what I did. Yeah. Because I was that same person that didn't know, like, what to start with, how to start, and I already had all the equipment. I already had my profile set up. It was just a matter of me, you know, starting. And I did that by steps, which made it a lot easier.
Nice.
Yeah.
Man, like, I have those challenges mm-hmm. when it comes to starting. Like, I'm not gonna lie, man, sometimes, like, I can't be a procrastinator mm-hmm. Where I tend to, you know, talk about it, what I'm going to do, but I don't take those steps to actually make those things fall in place for me.
Yeah.
So I do understand those things that you're mentioning right now, because
I battle with it as well, man. I battle with it all the time. It's not gonna go away. That's how I feel. But it's just, stop looking at things as, you know, the bigger picture and just break it down. Just right. How you're doing a math equation. You don't start with when you're doing a math equation, you gotta start with X. What's X?
Right.
You know? Yeah, so you really gotta just break it down and then go from the bottom up.
Makes sense.
Yeah. And if you have that type of thought process, not only with just YouTube, but just anything, I mean, your life becomes a lot easier. Long run. Think about it.
So pretty much being consistent and follow through and have some type of plan is what's going on.
Gotta be very organized. Very right. Organized. Yeah.
So how long did it take you to get started?
So I created my channel. Well, I mean, I actually had a channel and I was like, how old is that? I don't even remember how old I was. Youngest. I was super young.
Right.
And it was like, because when I was younger, I was super passionate about, like, animals. I still am now, but at that time, like, I was just reading books about animals, watching Animal Planet. So then I went ahead and created a channel about, like, animals. And at this time, I had, like, a hamster. I was volunteering at, like, a local PetSmart with the cats. So then I was, like, showcasing that off. So just that, and it was funny because I looking back at it now, my voice was different. I was a little kid, so it's just funny. But I already had a channel. Did I know what I was doing? No. But as years went on, I always knew that I wanted to start a YouTube channel.
Right.
But it just took until now, you know, I was able to actually afford, you know, actual resources like a quality camera, a laptop, you know, editing software, Photoshop. I got familiar with that. And those are just, you know, the things you need in order to start. So because I was comfortable with those things, I already had those things, I attained those skills, it just made it so much easier for me to start now. It just made a lot more sense. I could have even started it a couple years back, but I wasn't really dedicating the time to really think about exactly what I wanted to do. Until, you know, coronavirus hit, it just gave me a lot of time to think about a lot of things. And I thought about YouTube, I just started, you know, again, doing the steps, creating my channel, my name, getting my branding together, my social accounts together, making sure everything is, you know, is the same. Everything is almost, you know, it's everything looks alike. My branding is consistent. That's the word I was looking for. Everything is consistent.
Right.
And, you know, it just made sense. So I went ahead and started.
Nice.
Yeah.
So that's where I'm at right now. I'm actually putting things together. I'm taking the necessary steps to to get those things done. I'm glad you came in today so that you can share these things with me.
No, of course.
You know, I've been getting a lot of compliments about my haircuts and how I should start a YouTube page. So, you know, I'm like...
Nah, I definitely think it's something, you know, you should be doing, creating content around, like, whatever you're doing, that's, like, a plus.
Right.
So, even, you know, you could even turn this, you know, couple months, a year down the road, create a podcast, you know, it's just so many ways you can create content. Mm. It's really about how you think about it, your creativity. So, I think it's really good that you're starting now.
Yeah, man, I took your advice, man.
That's what's up.
Sometimes you just gotta, like, take that leap and see what it takes you.
Exactly.
So, you know, we're trying to follow your steps, man.
And another thing, two people gotta understand is that, I fall victim to it. I fell victim to it a couple of times. You know, looking at other people's success, which is horrible.
Right.
And really trying to, you know, compare myself, like, no, if you... Honestly, if you look at any YouTuber, like any big YouTuber,
right,
that really didn't blow up overnight, and you look at, you know, their older videos, their past videos, probably like their first couple videos, that's even if they have a viewable, you will see their quality was trash. Like, they didn't start with the best equipment. You know, they probably wasn't as, you know, easy going, you know, talking to the camera. You know, so it's all about time. You can't rush anything. You really just gotta let time go, and as time go, you know, you get better.
So pretty much being consistent is what will give you longevity.
Yes.
Was there any other YouTubers that you use as a motivation tool?
So I have my favorite YouTubers that I look up to, and I'm always watching their videos and seeing, you know, how they're getting these camera angles, how they're thinking about, how they're really, you know, how's their storytelling like? You know, how do they tell the story within their videos? Instead of just sitting there talking, like, about whatever topic they're talking about. It's really, like, giving that visualization of, like, what they're actually, you know, what they're trying to show you. Through the screen, you know?
The message there.
Yeah. And it's not by them just talking. It's like them really getting you, like, immersed in their video.
Wow.
And making it feel like you're there, you know? By their storytelling. But yeah, I mean, if you got your favorite YouTuber, just, you know, get inspired by them.
Yeah, man, there's a couple of YouTubers that I follow, and I enjoy watching them.
Yeah.
And, you know, they inspire me to, they give me the motivation to say, you know what, I can do this too. But one thing I notice, each one have their own different style, personality, and you know what? And I've been really, really thinking of what can I bring to the table, to the industry.
And another thing, just to put out there, is like, you gotta think about it like this. There's, even though YouTube is super, super saturated, there's honestly room for everybody, because
right,
everybody has their own specific audience. And you don't need a million subscribers to be like, if you're looking for financial freedom, you don't need a million followers. Because look, I mean, well, yeah, a million followers or a million subscribers. Because probably most times, 9 times out of 10, if your engagement is down, those followers may not even be like paying for a product you're promoting.
Right.
Watch it be like only 2 of them. And what's 2 out of a million? This is just an example. What's 2 out of a million? That's nothing. Versus having 1,000 core fans that are really, you know, they really rep what you embody. They're loyal.
Right.
Imagine, you know, just 1,000 people paying $20 for whatever you're selling. That's more valuable than a million subscribers and only 2 people are, you know, doing purchases or viewing, giving them engagement. Like, you gotta really think about it in that perspective too. So you really gotta just create that core audience, and that comes with, again, knowing what your niche is, you know?
So really, really make those engagement, getting to know your subscribers.
Yeah, making them feel like they know you, you know?
One thing I noticed too, man, when your subscribers feel like they can comment and you reply back to them, and also when you pretty much make them feel like, you know what, not only you're a subscriber, but you can also, like, you can reach out to me like I'm just a normal human being, you know, with information that I'm willing to look to pass on to, you know?
Yeah, you really gotta make them feel like you're not a number.
Right. Okay.
And by doing that, like, that's seriously putting in, like, let's say you got 1,000 subscribers, you're getting, like, 200 comments. That's like really showing love to those comments, like hearting them, favoring them, pinning one to the top. You know, one that's funny, you pin it to the top. You're like really having a conversation with them within the comment section. You know, that really what sparks, you know, engagement, retention, so that they don't go elsewhere.
Right.
You know, your likability. They can, you know, relate more. So you gotta really be creative on how you engage too, so.
YouTube, that's a cut right there, man. Let me know what you think. Let me know what you think about what we were talking about. If you have any feedback, you know, just drop it in the comments and we'll get back with you on that. Thank you.
Yeah, thank you guys. Appreciate it.